it's very emotional because you see like my mom, she doesn't have like fingerprints. And then because a lot of products, cleaning products, and so you see, and my father also used to you know, the walls, he used to scrap the walls. And then some houses are they didn't have the heater. And so in the winter, you work in the cold. That's why everything I do is for them, you know? Nothing was easy throughout my life. Maybe people say, oh, Kyle went to the United States, his family, they got a lot of money. They're completely wrong. 2001, my father and my mom, they lost their jobs in Brazil. And we had to find a way to eat, to pay the bills and everything. And we had one uncle cousin. He used to live in the United States. He'd been there for more than 30 years now. He has a painting company. And then he made the invite for my father, said, listen, bring your family here. You can work here. They can go to school. I was 10 years old. I didn't even know how to speak English. And then they said, okay, come. And then they said, okay, we want to come. Then we left everything behind. It was me, my mom, my father and my brother. And we went there to work. My father went to work. My mom also went to work. She was like cleaning house. And then from first of all, she worked in the school as a janitor to clean the school. And my father used to be a painter. Yeah, he started painting. And we went to school. Then slowly, you know, we got money and we started to reconstruct ourselves there. So it was very difficult because if this didn't happen, that's some crazy, you know, what to do? You don't have jobs in Brazil, it's very difficult. What are we gonna do? Then this happened. So me and my mom and my father, they worked so much, you know, it's very emotional because you see like, my mom, she doesn't have like fingerprints. And then because a lot of products, cleaning products, and so you see, and my father also used to you know, the walls, he used to scrap the walls. And then some houses are they didn't have the heater. And so in the winter, you work in the cold. So like these things makes you more strong, you know. You say, oh my God, know how much, and I always had everything that I wanted, you know, nice shoes, football shoes when I was starting playing there. So then when you're little, you don't have a clue of how it is. Then when you start getting old and then you start listening to the story of my father and my mom, you said, damn, that's why everything I do is for them, you know. And then Takeo it's a small island. I don't know if you know, it's a small island. On a school there was like 600 people. It's hard, I mean, to compare to some school that they have 10,000. You can take 11 players out of 10,000, you can make a stronger team. And we had 600 people, we had to take 11 players. So the team was not so good, but like we still beat the other teams, you know, because I used to make the difference and whatever. So I started catching the attention of a lot of people. Consequently, I got so many offers. You know, I had UCLA offers from to go to university, Notre Dame, St. John's. I still have the brochures all in my house. My father brought everything. My father has a big book of all the newspapers. You know, it's fun. It's something memorable. So we have it there. And then this is how it goes. When I was 16, then I decided. I said, no, listen, I want to try in Brazil. Here is getting too small for me. It was too easy. For me, it was getting too easy. So I said, listen, I need to say that. I didn't want to try in Brazil. And I was already over age, 16. In Brazil, you have to start young, so you can do the base to 10, 11, U12, U13 to get the bases. I was 16, and I told my father, listen, I want to go. My father said, if you want to go, this is the time now. My mother said, no, you have all the offers here. Are you crazy? You're gonna leave everything behind. I said, no, I need to go. Then I went back to Brazil 16, also had a very, I struggled so much because the players was 200% physically, technically, so powerful. Even when they're 16 in Brazil, it's crazy because, you know, they have the base. But I was always a guy that like, you know, no, I can do it. So step by step, I conquered my way to some clubs. And Successful in all of them. And this guy is amazing. I remember when I got there, he was it was 2013, and in 2010 he was I think the best player in the World Cup. And they had a Jabulani, and he used to shoot like crazy. He didn't even, he shoot both feet, left and right, same. Then he didn't talk too much with some other players. He was more like reserved. And with me, I was a young boy, and then he started talking so much with me. After training, he said, I used to finish training, I was going to the locker room, he said, Kyle, come back. He used to call me, say, here, come work with me here alone. And we'd stay there alone, me and him. You know, I'd do some crosses, he'd just control, shoot. I was having many fun, even though I was working for him to get him better, but I was learning so much. He might not showed me anything, but I was all his movements. Then he started saying, listen, when you control, put your body lower, you know, to shoot the ball. So like, this guy was like, oh, that's crazy. He's giving me so much attention, he doesn't even need this. But he was giving me so much attention that made me a big fan of him, you know, and made me respect him even more. I told you, he's a very reserved guy, very polite, intellectual, you know, like, we used to joke him, he plays with a suit. He plays like he's with suit. He's a very good guy. He's a footballer. I think all footballers, they have a little bit of advantage as a coach because they can understand what the players are going through because he already been in this situation before. You know? I think he's going to be a great coach. Peñarol, there's resources, they have a lot of fans, you know. They're going to expect a lot from him. I think he's ready. Like I said, I don't want to take nobody's place. I respect all the players that have been there. I know all the players. Very good players, very good guys, you know, very professional. And so I cheer so much for the national team so they can do a good any cup that they entered, qualification to the World Cup. I want to see, it's good for the country, it's good for the competitions here. So I'm here cheering for them, you know, if I'm with them or not. If it does happen, that will be something I actually give back to the country for everything they gave to me. Again, I don't want to take nobody's place. I just want to be together and help. I think I can help a lot. Oh, I thought it was a joke because first of all, I stay on Instagram and then I see many things pop up like, oh, Kai Alain. But then I received a massive invasion of Alain fans in my Instagram social media. So I was like, wow, maybe this can be true. And then, of course, you always dream to play in such a powerful club, especially here in UAE. We know how what Alain represents, and very excited. And then I said, hey, maybe this could be true. I don't know, but you know, Instagram, social media. Then I see the fans, and I said, okay. I was hoping it was true, but then I also with the foot back and a step back. But then things started getting more intensive. And then we did receive a phone call, and then we got very excited. Then it was just a matter of, how you say, negotiation. It was a little bit twist because Al-Wasl fan was also disappointed, but I already gave my response to that. Al-Wasl administration, they needed the money. Al-Wasl needed the money. Al-Wasl was going through a difficult period. Maybe it is still, I don't know. But I was going through a difficult period, so I'm happy that I could help Al-Wasl back, you know, at least with the money that of my transfer. I'm sure Al-Wasl can regroup and can do a good season. Definitely a different experience, you know. Everybody said, oh, Kai, when your daughter was going to be born, or your son, whatever, you're gonna go crazy. And then it is. And then when my daughter came to life, it made me another man, you know, more responsible. So there's no words that can describe. Whoever is watching this, whoever has a kid, they know what I'm talking about. So today my life surrounds about my daughter, you know. I would do everything for her. Everything I do is for her. So I love him, man. I love him. I'm just having fun. I had fun waiting for her to grow even more, and actually to make her a very good woman. Fabio is a great guy, also a great player. We know, we've seen so much Fabio. it goes both the way around, you know, like I think me and him, we understood each other very well. Also because we played together 5 years, so I know all his movements. I know what he likes to receive. He knows what I like to receive. So it was very easy. We could understand each other by look, you know, like when you control, he doesn't even need to look at me. He knows exactly what I'm gonna do. But like I said, it's time. We stayed a long time together, so we already knew. So it was like a chemistry. And we also had Ronaldo Mendes, which helped us so much. This guy is an amazing guy. This guy also made me a better player as a professional. This guy is amazing. And it is what it is, you know. Football, sometimes, you know, you come and go, a different club. Maybe in a few years we're going to be together again. So you never know. So I wish him all the best. I wish also Al-Wasl the best. I hope they can grow and do always better seasons.